Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salam ala Rasulillah wa ba'd. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah thumma alhamdulillah. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for granting us the tawfeeq to find the month of Ramadan. And praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for granting us the tawfeeq to find this, which is the first Jumuah in the beloved month of Ramadan, in this blessed month of Ramadan, subhanallah. So what should we do in the month of Ramadan? This is my nasiha today. No doubt, we know that this is a month of fasting. As Allah says, kutiba alaykum as-siyam kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun. Allah says, O you who believe, fasting has been prescribed for you like the people before, so that la'allakum tattaqun, that perhaps you can attain taqwa, subhanallah. If Allah was suggest to link Ramadan to the month of fasting, that would be sufficient for us. But no, my dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala linked the month of Ramadan with the Quran. Shahru Ramadan alladhi unzila fihi al-Quran. In the month of Ramadan in which we sent the Quran. So my nasiha today is about how to connect with the Quran. No doubt, every one of us, we want to be those that are Ahlul Quran, Ahlul Quran and Ahlul Sunnah. But if you want to emulate the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, then you need to be somebody who is connected to the Quran. They came and asked Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, Kayfa khulukuhu? Kayfa khulukuhu an-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam? How was his characteristic? How was the characteristics of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam? To which Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha replied, Kana khulukuhu al-Quran. That his characteristics was the Quran. So if you ever want to emulate the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, we learn about the book of Allah Azza wa Jal, and then we take his example, and that what we find from the prophetic tradition. May Allah grant us the tawfiq. So how do we connect with the Quran? First and foremost, we need to appreciate that Allah Azza wa Jal, when he sent the revelation, the first verse that was revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was Iqra. Iqra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq. Read in the name of thy Lord that created you. So one of the first things that we need to do is pick up the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. Either pick up the book of Allah Azza wa Jal or open our Quran app. We need to be people that on a daily basis, we read the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. It's so important that we do this. Because quite often what we do is we say that we are distracted. We say that we are busy. We say that sometimes we're not even in the mood to read the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. Rather, we shouldn't be like this. Ramadan is an excellent opportunity because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has connected Ramadan with the Quran. So it's an excellent opportunity for us to say, normally we are distracted. Maybe I'm going to spend in the month of Ramadan less time watching TV, less time even on social media, unless there's something good that I want to follow. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you the tawfiq to find some more time to open the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. And remember, there is such a reward in reciting the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. As the Prophet ﷺ said that for every letter that is recited, there is 10 reward. And the Prophet ﷺ said, La akul alif lam mim, la akul alif lam mim harfan. I'm not saying to you that alif lam mim is a harf. Walakin alif harf, lam harf, mim harf. That the alif and lam and mim are their separate letters. So you get so much reward for reciting the book of Allah Azza wa Jal during this month of Ramadan. So Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what about the person that finds it difficult in reciting the book of Allah? I mean, there's a struggle going on. To which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, for that person, there is ajran. There is two rewards. That for that person, there is two rewards because of the fact that they struggle. So there may be some of us that we do struggle to read the book of Allah. Firstly, we may struggle because we don't find time. May Allah grant you barak in the time. Especially in this month of Ramadan, to be able to find some time to read the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. But secondly, also that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it easy for you so that the Quran rolls off your tongue. You find it easy to read the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. And to also read the book of Allah Azza wa Jal in your salah, to recite the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. So may Allah make us those who are Ahlul Quran by first and foremost opening the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. Secondly, my dear brothers and sisters, what I do want to remind us about is that to have Fahmul Quran is so important, the understanding of the Quran. Because the Quran came to change a people, the mindset of a people. It came as Hudan Linnas, Wubainati Mila Huda Wal Furqan. That is a guidance for mankind and a clarification of the proof and a Furqan, mean a criterion for you to follow. So imagine that we read the book of Allah Azza wa Jal, but we don't understand what has been said. How will it guide us thereafter? So we need to be active in trying to understand the Quran. So there's two ways, my dear brothers and sisters, that we can try to do this. Firstly, we can go to the original source language. What is the original source language? Lughatul Arabiya. We can make it a journey, a task for us, a life journey, to learn the Arabic language. Because why? اللغة العربية مهمة جدا. It's very important لأنها لغة القرآن لغة السنة سبحانه وتعالى. It is the language of the Quran and the Sunnah. يعني من كتب أحاديث, the books of أحاديث. So if you want to access the original revelation as it came, in the language that it came, then we learn the Arabic language. So we learn how to read the Quran from the Mus'haf, the Arabic language. And with that, we'll get the ma'na, the meaning, because we're learning what each word means. So for example, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابِ, Allah says, that is the book. Then we know that this is, you know, language that we use in everyday language, because Allah speaks to you in a language that the people are supposed to understand. The reason it was sent in an Arabic language to the Arab people is that when Allah spoke to them, they would understand. So this is what we want to do, my dear brother and sister. We want to actively try to at least make some attempt to learn the Arabic language, because that time will be well invested for you, subhanAllah. You know, it will allow you to draw this intense relationship with Allah Azza wa Jal, because you will understand the words as you speak them. It will cause you to increase in iman. Fazadum iman, as Allah says, that those people, they would increase in iman. It will give you khushua. Now, when you read the salah in Arabic, subhanAllah, what will do, it will give you the khushua, because you understand the Arabic language. All of this, mashallah. And much more, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, there is shifa and rahmah. There is shifa and rahmah for you. So there's cure and there's mercy for you. But that will come, my dear brothers and sisters, if we understand that the book of Allah was sent to guide us, to help us, to aid us, to be a criterion for us to follow and for also to adhere to. So this is what we want to do, my dear brothers and sisters. We want to firstly read the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. Then secondly, we want to try to understand. Now, if we can't understand the Arabic language, then know for us that we still ask to have comprehension with the Quran. أَفَلَا يَتَدَبُّرُونَ الْقُرَانِ, will you not comprehend the Quran? So then what do? Alhamdulillah, we have the tarjama, we have the translation of the Quran. At least try to understand the words that you're saying by going to the tarjama. But much better than this, my dear brothers and sisters, would be to go and enroll in a course or follow some sort of tafsir of the Quran, a translation with interpretation and meaning of the Quran. And we have the means at our fingertips today, subhanAllah. If you can either go to join a class in real life setting, but if not online, join an online class or follow media, all of the platforms that we have that are dedicated to teaching people the Quran, the authentic meaning of the Quran. Follow the scholars that are dedicated to this, inshallah ta'ala, and try to understand the Quran. The next thing we want to do is make a habit of us listening to the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. Whilst you read, whilst you understand, but also listen to the Quran, subhanAllah. Now, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say to the Sahaba, read. And when one occasion, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said, Ya Rasulallah, you want me to recite to you, yet the book was revealed to you, subhanAllah. You want me to recite the book to you, yet the book was revealed to you. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I like to hear it from others. So we should tune our ears, especially in this month of Ramadan, where we are going to censor ourselves a little bit from the things that we listen to and so on, and tune our ears to want to listen to the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. Let it move us. Let us listen to the Quran, and those who are learning the Quran, let it improve our recitation as well by hearing those who are proficient and expert in the recitation. Let us do this, but let it move us as well. Because imagine when you hear the Quran, and that is the thing, it should have an effect on your heart, on your qalb. So let us make it a habit to listen to the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. The last advice I want to give you is to try to memorize some of the book of Allah Azza wa Jal as well. Why? Subhanallah, the amount of Quran that you know will be your hujjah, will be a proof for you on the day of judgment, subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us a barakah in the time, inshallah ta'ala. Everyone has the same time, but Allah will give barakah to those who want to do some good for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. So what you want to do, just invest some time by trying to memorize. So you know some surahs, majority of us, what we tend to do is go through the surahs that we learned when we were younger. What do you want to do? Yes, alhamdulillah. But try to increase maybe another verse from another chapter and so on, little bit by little bit by little bit. What will this do for you, subhanAllah? Firstly, it will make you have this stronger connection with the Quran, and also give you a variety. Okay, because one of the things that we want to do is that when we read our salah, for example, when we read a normal khamsa salawat and the nafila, but out of that time, remember, we have like opportunity for taraweeh now, we have tahajjud in the latter part of the night, qiyamul layl, which is to pray through the night. You can have a variety of different chapters. So you're not praying in a robotic manner. You are actually focused on the thing that you're trying to do, which is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by understanding His book and by reciting His book and being sincere towards Him. So be those that tried at least to make some effort to recite some of the book, because the Quran will be hujja laka aw alaik. The Quran will come for you as hujja. Those that recite the book, the Quran will say, Ya Allah, your servant here used to take time out of his day to recite to me your book. And subhanAllah, forgive him. And we know the fadl of the one who memorizes the Quran, subhanAllah, that Allah subhanAllah honors those who memorize the Quran with a taj, which is a crown, and honors their parents as well, subhanAllah. This is the fadl of the one who tries to memorize the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. May Allah grant us the tawfeeq in this month of Ramadan to reap the maximum benefits that we can. May Allah make us those who are from the muttaqeen, those who are conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we are those that try to draw close to Allah Azza wa Jal by our fasting, by being mindful of our fasting, but also because this is the month of Ramadan, that we are people who try to draw close to Allah Azza wa Jal by the Quran, by trying to learn how to read it, by trying to understand it, by listening to the Quran, by trying to memorize the Quran, and most importantly thereafter is try to implement the Quran in our lives. May Allah grant us the tawfiq to get the maximum benefit once again from the month of Ramadan. Allahumma taqabbal minna innaka antas samiul alim wa tub alayna innaka antat tawwabur rahim bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.